Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dean Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.2, Problem 6. This is Section 3.2, Problem 6. It says maximize z equals 5x plus 7y, subject to 2x plus y is less than or equal to 10, x plus y is less than or equal to 8, x is greater than or equal to 0, and y is greater than or equal to 0. So like the previous problems in this section, this is a four-part process. The first part is to graph the feasible region. So I'm going to start by graphing the linear inequality 2x plus y is less than or equal to 10. And to get that graph, I'm going to make a little xy chart next to it and fill it in by pretending I have x plus y equals 10 instead of less than, and find two points that have coordinates that make that equals true. I'll start by letting x equal 0. So if x is 0, the 2x essentially just goes away, and I have y equals 10. And I can generate a second point by letting y equal 0. Again, I'm pretending it equals 10, not less than. So I have 2x equals 10. So to make 10 equals 10, the x would have to be 5 to make the equation true. So I have 0, 10, and 5, 0. I'll put that on a graph. 0, 10 is over 0 up 10. And 5, 0 is over 5 up 0. I have my points on the graph. I'll connect them with a straight line. I'm going to make this line blue. Now I have to decide where to shade on that blue line, above it or below it. So in order to do that, I'm going to choose a test point that's not on the line. I like to use 0, 0 when I can. 0, 0 is not on the line I just drew. So the x value and y value of my test point go into my 2x plus y is less than or equal to 10. Gives me the statement 0 is less than 10. Certainly true, 0 is less than 10. So my test point came from the underneath side. The result was true, so it's the underneath side that's shaded. Now, the next line I draw, I'm going to do in a different color for clarity. I'm going to do the next one in red. So the next thing I have to draw is x plus y is less than or equal to 8. So again, I'm going to pretend it's x plus y equals 8, and I'm going to make my little xy chart next to it and find two points with coordinates that make x plus y equals 8. There are a lot of points, but the easier ones to find are when you use 0. So first I'll let x equal 0. I have y equals 8. Next, I'll let y equals 0, then x equals 8. So that one's fairly easy. So let me put 0, 8, and 8, 0 on the graph, connect them, do my shading. So 0, 8 is over 0 up 8. Draw that on the graph. The other one, 8, 0, is over 8 up 0. Put that on the graph. Connect those with a straight line. Again, I'm going to make this line red so it stands out from the blue one that I did first. Now I have to decide if I shade above the line or below it. Same process as I did with the blue line. I'm going to pick a test point. I'm going to use my 0, 0 that I like to use the most because it's not on the line. I get to use it. So if x is 0, y is 0, I get the statement 0 is smaller than 8, which is true. So since my test point gave me a true result, the test point's in the shaded region, which is below. Now the next linear inequality, x is greater than or equal to 0, is telling me that any point in my feasible region has to have a positive x-coordinate, which means I have to be to the right of the y-axis. Anything to the left of the y-axis would have a negative x-value, so I have to be to the right. And y is greater than or equal to 0 says at any point my feasible region has to have a positive y-coordinate. My points of my feasible region have to be above the x-axis, because if I go below, the y-values become negative, so I have to be above. Now, where all that shading overlaps is my feasible region. So I'll just darken that in a little bit. So the more heavily shaded area is the area that satisfies all of my constraints simultaneously. That's the feasible region. So that's step one, graph the feasible region. It's been graphed. Step two, label the corner points. Again, the majority of them are easy. 0, 8 is a corner point. Again, 0, 10 is not because it doesn't touch my feasible region. 0, 8 is a corner point. It's on the edge of the feasible region. 0, 0 is a corner point. It's not going to be the maximum, but it is a corner point, 0, 0. 5, 0 is a corner point. And the point of intersection between the blue line and the red line is also a corner point. Now again, because I've drawn a fairly accurate graph, you can probably read it right off the graph. But the right way to do it, especially if you have just a completely freehand graph, is to take those two linear inequalities, write them as equations, and solve them simultaneously. So the first one, the one that I drew in blue, is 2x plus y, and I'm going to write it as equals 10. And the other one will be x plus y equals 8. Now, I'd like to solve these simultaneously. I want to cancel one of the variables. Y is easier to cancel, though I should get the same answer no matter which one I do. So I'll leave the top equation unchanged. It will continue to be 2x plus y equals 10. The bottom one, however, I'm going to multiply everything times negative 1 to make the y negative. So I'm going to make my symbol here and say times negative 1. Negative 1 times x is negative x, negative 1 times y is negative y, and negative 1 times 8 is negative 8. So everything in the equation was multiplied times negative 1. Now if I combine the two equations I have at this step of the problem, I will cancel the y. 2x and negative x gives me x, positive y, negative y cancels, and then positive 10, negative 8 gives me a positive 2. So the point at which the red line and the blue line intersect has an x coordinate of 2. Now to find the y coordinate, I can take my x value of 2, plug it into either of the original equations, and find y. And I should get the same answer either way, but the bottom one's much easier, I think. If x is 2, I have 2 plus y is 8. Well, y has to be 6. 2 plus 6 would make 8 equals 8. And by the graph, I can see that 6 seems like a correct y value, and the x seems like a correct x value. The x is 2. So step 2 is label the corner points. They're labeled. Step 3 is fill in the chart. So the chart has three columns. The first column is for the corner points. The middle column I make a little bit wider for the object function, which for this problem is z equals 5x plus 7y. And the last column is for the output. Put some rows in my chart to keep it neat. I list all my corner points. So one of them is 0, 8. Another is 2, 6. Another one is 5, 0. And the last one will be 0, 0. Again, I know that's not the maximum, but I'll put it in anyway. Now, put the x and y value of each corner point into the object function. So for the first corner point of 0, 8, the object function would be z equals 5 times x becomes 5 times 0. 7y becomes 7 times 8. 5 times 0 is 0. 7 times 8 is 56. So 0 plus 56 gives me an output of 56 for the first corner point that I test. The next one is 2, 6. So z equals 5 times x is 5 times 2. And 7 times y becomes 7 times 6. 5 times 2 is 10. 7 times 6 is 42. 10 plus 42 is 52. And the next corner point is 5, 0. So z equals 5 times x is 5 times 5. 7 times y is 7 times 0. 5 times 5 is 25. 7 times 0 is 0. 25 plus 0 is 25. And finally, the 0, 0, the last corner point is going to give you an output of 0. You're going to get 5 times x becomes 5 times 0. 7 times y is 7 times 0, which winds up giving you 0 plus 0, which is 0. So that's step 3. Fill in the chart. There's the chart. We filled it in. Step 4 is state your solution. So where we want to maximize the outputs that we have to choose from are 56, 52, 25, or 0. Well, the biggest output is clearly the 56, so that's the maximum. So for step 4, state your solution, we would write maximum of 56. You have to say where you got the 56, so you put at the point. Now the 56 came from the point 0, 8. So the maximum of 56 at the point 0, 8.